Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Felicia. I'm a Nigerian YouTuber based in Lagos. Just in case you're new here, welcome. Thank you for clicking on the video to watch it, okay? Don't forget to subscribe before you leave, okay? Join this fun channel. And to my returning subscribers, my home G's, my comment section gang, the people that gas me up like you guys, thank you so much for all that you do for this channel. I appreciate you guys, okay? So you may be wondering why we are here, like three of us, looking like we just rolled out of our bed, okay? So we're having an argument in the car. I and my cousin are just out here. It's really a hot day, so we're just chilling in the car, enjoying some cool AC. But we are also going through Instagram as well. And then there was this particular post I read out. I was arguing with my cousin at the back, Tucci. Okay, before I get into the post, you guys, if you're interested in knowing what this car video is all about, just keep on watching, all right? Back again, let me now get into the gist, okay? So we have been sitting here in the car and we're just online. I was going through Insta blog. I usually go to Insta blog for gist, yeah. So I saw this particular post by Reno Omokri. You guys, many of you already know him. He's an influential person in Nigeria, but I'm not sure he's based in Nigeria. Reno Omokri is like, he's more like an activist.
Oh, Reno Nuggets.
Yeah. So he put up a post on his Twitter and Insta blog reposted it, and that's what I was reading. So let me read it and I'll tell you guys why this conversation is interesting, okay? I'll probably put this post on the screen anyway. So he says, the greatest waste of education is sitting in an office from 8 to 5 because of salary. Make your education count. Start a business, even if you have a job. Make something or sell something. Don't spend your life just existing in an office prison. Hashtag Freelia Sharibu. Hashtag Reno Nuggets. Yeah. So this is the post we saw, and yeah, you guys know that I'm not even an office person. I'm an entrepreneur. I work for myself. But my cousin is a HR professional in her company.
Hi guys.
Big company, okay?
My name is Tochi.
Yes, so introduce yourself.
My name is Tochi. I've worked
how many years now?
I think over 5 years.
Over 5 years, okay.
So I'm a HR person. So yeah. I think I have a lot of knowledge in this question that she's talking about.
Okay. So you guys, from my own, I was kind of arguing with her that you don't necessarily have to start, not everybody in the world, like everybody in life has to start up a business. That some people are just meant to like have careers and then, yeah, grow in their careers, whatever. But she's of a different opinion, and she's even the one that is working me. I've not really held a job for like, I don't know how, I can't say this is how long I've stayed in an office setting, but she's been working for 5 years and she has a different opinion. She's of the opinion that Reno is right, and I'm of the opinion that he's not. That it's not necessary, it's not compulsory that everybody must have a business, because some people are not cut out to be entrepreneurs, and some people, even if they try, they probably not make it as entrepreneurs because it's not in their DNA. I don't know how to put it. So another person on Insta blog also reposted it from his post, a reply. And Angela Eguavon, I don't even know this person, but everybody's an actress in Nigeria anyway. You guys don't call for me in case he's a popular actress, so I don't know her. Angela Eguavon, Von or whatever, I'll put it on the screen as well. She says, venturing into business is not for everybody, which is what I'm saying too. How can you say the greatest source of education is sitting in an office from 8 to 5 because of salary? Like really, a lot of people have excelled and still excelling from doing only salary jobs. Not everyone can handle or have a business. That doesn't mean their education is wasted. It's pretty insensitive to say that one's education is wasted because they have chosen to stick to their 8 to 5 jobs. Do what works for you and stick with it. Don't go into something you don't understand and now bring high BP upon yourself. Let nobody pressure you unnecessarily. It's only the living that's useful and makes money. Okay, bye.
So she's agreeing with you.
She's agreeing with me.
While Reno is on this Reno's page right now, because you guys, you know, when you don't work in an office setting, people tend to believe, oh, okay, having businesses is not for everybody. I am from both worlds.
Yeah,
I work and I have a business. Fine. I am from both worlds. And I can tell you, mm-hmm. I've had the opportunity to sit with retirees mm-hmm. or those before they even retire. I've had to organize trainings for mm-hmm. people that are about to retire. And okay. I can tell you this. Most people don't know what they want to do after they leave the office setting. Mm-hmm. And that is very, very, very poor. Mm-hmm. That is why you have a lot of old people not knowing, you know, they're just loafing around, standing in front of a pension office, looking for one pension fund to the other. That's true. How yeah. many rich people can you see in this country? How many uneducated youths are out there? Somebody will sit down in the office, 20-something is in the office, fine. 30-something person is in the office. 40-something. What happens to the 20-something person that is just leaving the school? Do you understand? First yeah. of all, you are not creating jobs for people coming out. Mm-hmm. Nigeria is becoming poorer. People are saying government, government, but we are the ones who are supposed to make the country rich. Mm-hmm. We are the ones who are supposed to provide this. It's not only government that can provide employment for people. Yeah. I mean, yeah. you yourself, you can create something and provide employment for people.
Yeah.
So, Mio. Everybody, like, I've had situations whereby people leave our office as senior managers and they are still hovering around the office looking for one contract job that they can easily do around what they were doing in the office. So
mm-hmm.
they did not maybe find a skill that they were good at or learn one thing or the other. No.
Yeah.
But, and then when you even listen to some retirement trainings, they'll tell you how to take care of your health, they can steal it from the white people, you know,
mm-hmm.
because those ones have maybe saved money or left and become mechanics or, you know, all those kind of small jobs. Well, here mm-hmm. in Nigeria, now a mechanic cannot. can. I don't know, my own opinion, as you are working, you should also find something else
on
the
that
side
you can retire
to do.
Into, right?
I'm telling you.
Like, it makes sense. If you put it in this direction, in this way, yeah, it makes sense. But I'm saying, like, okay, in your lifetime as a salary earner,
mm-hmm.
you're saying that you have to have something that you're doing as a side hustle.
Babe, yes. You have to have so something.
What, okay, as she now put it now, some people venture into things that they cannot actually, like, fine, you're able to be a business person and also a working class person, right?
Mm-hmm.
Some people cannot even merge more than one thing at a time. Some people can only work for people. Like, if everybody owns a business, who's going to work for all the other people that
the young people that are coming out? No, I'm not saying working for somebody is wrong.
Okay.
The truth working is, you need to work for somebody to understand how most of all these things work. Some people mm-hmm. are just, that's if you look at the Igbo apprenticeship system,
mm-hmm.
that's the way I feel working for somebody should be like.
Be like, okay.
You go in for like 3 to 5 years, understand, you know, different aspects, go into a field you enjoy,
mm-hmm.
understand what it's all about, then yes. go out and build it. Mm-hmm. What are you doing, lifting table and dropping it back for 5, 7, 10 years, 20 years, some people 35. What? Saba. Most people on the same position. Understand, maybe Reno did not explain because really you don't need to explain everything down, on social media.
Even do that,
yeah. But he is coming he's coming from a strong point. Everybody, most people that work and later come out become either poor. Or they start suffering one sickness.
All their savings, everything will now
go because gone they really because they don't know what you put it into.
Even Maxwell was telling me something about that. Like, a lot of people, where his brother works, anyway, when they retire with a whole lot of money. They still pay them even after they are retired, mm-hmm. like yearly, I don't know what they call it.
Oh, really?
But they can't, there are some of his brother's friends that they can't even say, okay, this is what they're using their money to do. There's nothing tangible because they don't even know how to invest their money. They don't know what to transition into. So it makes sense when you bring it this way. But I'm also of the opinion that not everybody necessarily has to be a business person. So I don't know.
See, yeah, and that's where partnership
probably
comes
maybe
into place.
Maybe if you're a career person, then.
Oh my god.
Sorry guys. The children came out and then disrupted our video anyway. So I'm of the opinion that it's not necessarily that you have to transition into a business after you maybe retire. Maybe you're doing a business. What if you have your own, you now set up your own organization and then still continue that career
beautiful.
Path.
Beautiful. But the truth is, it is actually going to be difficult to come out at 60. And start setting up an organization.
Well, you have to have started it.
Yes.
But it's not like it's a business. Now. It's still
yes.
career.
No, it's still career, but it is now, it has become your business because yeah. you are going to make profit. It becomes other people's career, but your business.
Yeah, yeah, true.
So,
Okay, guys, we are going to just, I don't know, my cousin, my other cousin was just still down here, not saying anything, but I don't know, probably cut that off in the clip. So, you guys, what are your thoughts? Are you with me? Are you with her? I kind of understand what she's saying, but I still have it in the back of my head that it's not everybody that necessarily.
Let me also say something. Like what the actress was talking about, a lot of people can be entrepreneurs.
Yes.
My dear. Running something with another friend, I don't know anything about what he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing. Yeah. Eh? But the beauty about business partnership, most people run away, oh, I don't want to have a partner, I want to eat all the money by myself. Come on. You mustn't have all the skills.
Mm-hmm.
You must not. And then yeah, even if you don't have this particular skill, you can go and get the training, go and get learning on that particular skill. I mean, we tie ourselves down too much in this Nigeria. Okay.
Do you blame people? People have a lot of things to do.
I have a friend that left uni.
Use your life savings and go and start a business that will flop.
A lot of people ask, but learn a skill. Learn a skill at least. Most times, you just find people in an office, maybe doing a messenger job for a very long time.
No, those ones are like, it doesn't even make sense. Like, even if it's not messenger, like, there are just some roles that if there's no opportunity for growth for you in a company, then what are you now doing there? Like, if you're not growing,
you see those women selling tomato in the market, and you come maybe with your fancy handbag and you're looking at them like, oh boy, those women,
they're making mad money.
Yeah, they're doing your sitting outside the office. The conductor, do you know how much his daily income is? Calculate your daily income, please.
When you take your salary and
divide it by 22. Times how many days? That's when you know that you're not making anything.
So it's important to have a side. Yes, I agree with having a side hustle, but the only part I'm saying is that, like the actress said, not everybody must be an entrepreneur. But then, whatever rocks your boat, me, I'm for being an entrepreneur and having a side hustle. But I just feel also that there are some people whose life goals is just career.
Because maybe they might have tried one thing that didn't work for them.
Yeah.
We should always remember that
there are many things to try.
And the beauty about business is trying.
Trying, bro.
You try this thing, it fails. You look at one person I always talk about, to people, but she does not know I talk about her, is Noye, your sister. Noye has tried businesses.
So many businesses.
But
like,
see the
so
one
many.
That she's doing right now.
Yeah,
it is booming.
This one is like,
I beg.
Clicked.
Please.
She has finally found her
about, as whenever I'm talking to people about this thing, I use her as an example.
She doesn't waste time. Once she's not seeing... Oh, she's not seeing
don't even look back and say, oh my God, this thing took my money. Yes, it took your money. But move on. That's beauty about business. So.
But it's also Nigeria is hard. So it might be hard for some people to move on when the business, because they might have used their whole life savings.
Babe, your popsy didn't go school. forget. Another person I used, one of my role models, my dad.
Okay.
They did not go to school.
Yes, of
but
course,
men
yeah.
put them and put maybe an MD of one place.
Yeah.
An MD might borrow money from this bank, borrow this one just to build that one house.
Yeah, yeah.
But man, you see these men that went
to
go and
do
apprenticeship
yeah.
system.
It's true.
They would have done too many
so
things.
So far, yeah.
Please,
definitely.
You guys, I see. These
guys
are my
first
time coming out here.
Start a business.
Whether it's to buy tomato, put on top of table, whether it's to sell hair.
Yeah.
Ah,
you know your calling. I'm also a believer of live and let live. You know your calling. Do your work, your normal business, whatever. But always have an end goal in mind. Like, what
I'm
am I going to move on to after
and
I'm
then
done
the truth,
working.
One the beautiful thing about working for somebody is if anything happens, you are off, you're bringing the next person. So, please.
This absent girl, this is a serious video.
this
is supposed to be a serious video. You've not even made
before
any
you start thinking of that office or how you can grow, think of yourself first.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? It's until you can take care of yourself, you know you can take care of other things around you.
Yeah. This was a fun impromptu video.
I'm out.
Fun impromptu video. We should do more of this. Like, I just thought of we're just about to start arguing. I'm like, you know what? Let's film this because this is a nice topic. You guys, let's continue this conversation in the comment section, okay? Let's continue it over there. Chizo, where did you get German mango from? Who bought it?
Kissy.
Can you imagine? I'm not here about it. Let me just end this video. Let me go take German mango. Okay, guys. So I'm going to be ending this video right here. Let me leave you guys so we can continue our girl gist and let me go and get mango. I'm seeing mango. The mango is just feeling the atmosphere. Let me go and get some mangoes and enjoy myself. You guys, don't forget to subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye. Bye. Guys. Say bye-bye.
Bye. Hope you enjoyed yourself.
This is not anything you said in this video.